Hi friends, this is me, Harshavi Handal. Today I'm going to tell about superficial mycosis. And the superficial mycosis mainly are divided into three main types, or it is of three main types. Basically, it is Tinea, that is also known as Pityriasis versicolor, and Piadra, and Dermatophytes. Okay, coming to Tinea or Pityriasis versicolor. Tinea or Pityriasis versicolor causes hypo or hyperpigmented macule. Hypo or hyperpigmented macule. It is lipophilic. Therefore, lipophilic means it loves to be in a media where there is more of lipids. So, it is more commonly seen in areas which are more with glands like sebaceous glands. These are present in upper body, right? More sebaceous glands are present in upper part of the body. So this Malassezia furfurca hypo and hyperpigmented macule usually are found in upper part of the body. And not only that macule kind of lesion which it causes, it also causes seborrheic dermatitis. And we should know how it will be seen in microscopy culture and wood slam. Coming to microscopy, Tinea, that is Malassezia furfur, is actually, I had said before that in my previous video, that is, it is a yeast-like fungus. So, yeast-like fungus means it is between that spherical and hyphal forms, that kind of group. Okay, and culture, it is fried egg appearance. And in wood slam, due to the pigment called pteridin is a fluorescent compound, okay. It gives on wood slam, it gives golden yellow fluorescence. And yeast like or the appearance is known as spaghetti and meatball appearance. Just remember, Tinea malassezia furfur causes macule, that is hypo and hyperpigmented macules, and it can also cause seborrheic dermatitis. It is most common in the upper part of the body because it is rich in sebaceous gland, and these organisms are lipophilic. Coming to the diagnosis, we should know how it looks microscopically, that is yeast like spaghetti and meatball, and culture it is fried egg appearance, and in wood slam it is golden yellow due to pteridin pigment, okay? So, this is all about Tinea versicolor, also known as Pityriasis versicolor. Coming to Piadra. Piadra causes nodules on hair shaft. When Piadra occurs, the only treatment left, actual treatment is removal of the hair, okay? Just removal of the hair causes disappearance of that infection. There are two types of Piadra, that is white Piadra and black Piadra. You should remember white Piadra because on culture, this white Piadra gives white or cream colonies or creamy colonies, cream color colonies. Black Piadra on culture gives brown to black colonies. And you should remember the organisms most common, like white Piadra is caused by Trichospora bigzilli. Black Piadra it is Piadra horti. Just remember, when there is bijli light, there is always white. Bijli jaa dalne par sab dikhta hai, white dikhta hai. So it is bijli is white, And when something is hot, like hot vessel, when you touch over time, your hand gets black the next day. So hot is for black. So white pyrrha is by Trichosoma bacilli, black pyrrha is by Pyrrha horti. This is all about Pyrrha. And you should also remember that on microscopy, these are septate hyphae. Okay, they show septate hyphae. Septate hyphae. Septate hyphae, and this, as I said, it is yeast-like. And coming to dermatophytes are a group of fungus wherein it is keratophilic. It is keratophilic, that is, love to be in a media where it is rich in keratin, but it cannot invade deeper. It just affect the superficial layer of the skin, nail, hair, etc. But it cannot invade further. So only it is grouped under superficial mycosis. And as I had classified in my previous video, dermatophytes belong to moults, that is hyphal type. So in moults, it is, as I had said, it is septate hyphae with irregular branching. And coming to the most common sites or the sites where these dermatophytes organisms cause the lesion, trichophyton. Remember, basically it can affect your skin, nail, and hair. This trichophyton affects all the three. Remember, trichophyton ka naam mein hi hai three. Three. That is skin, nail, and hair. Microsporum, remember, when you read micro, it should go to your head, right? So micro is near your head. So just think of the area that is your forehead. What is there? There you have skin, and next to that you have hair. So microspora is hair and skin. Epidermophyton, think of this region. What is there here? That is nail hair or skin. So these are the lesions. So the question in the exam can be, which among the following region epidermophyton cannot cause the lesion? Then your answer should be hair, like that. So you should be able to answer this question based on this. Trichophyton, all three. Micro, when you read micro, it should go to your head. That is forehead region. You just imagine there is skin, and you also have the hair. So skin and hair is microsporum. And coming to epidermophyton, it is nail and skin. And coming to culture, on culture, it gives cottony, velvety growth, powdery growth. And depending upon this various species, it can be white or any other color depending on the various species. Okay, white or any other color, it depends on the species. And on oat slam, only few dermatophytes show what is known as apple green fluorescence. So let's summarize dermatophytes is keratophilic moults. And it is, as I mentioned previously, it is septate hyphae with irregular branching, and it includes three main types, that is trichophyton, microsporum, and epidermophyton. Tricho affects all three regions, micro affects forehead, that is skin and hair, epidermophyton affects this region, that is nail and skin. And coming to culture, it gives cotton, velvety, powdery growth. Depending on the species, different colors also. Some show white, some show other different colors. And wood slab, only few of them show apple green fluorescence on wood slab. We have learned one more wood slab, that is golden yellow fluorescence by Malassezia furfur, and here apple green fluorescence by few of the dermatophytes. Coming to dermatophytes can cause tinea, what is known as tinea, chorion, flavus, ectothrix, and endothrix. Coming to tinea, also known as ringworm, The lesions are red, itchy, itchy in characteristics. If the tinea affects the head, it is known as tinea capitis. If it affects the body, it is known as corporis. If it affects the groin area, it is called crurus. And if it affects hand, it is called manum. If it affects feet, it is called pedis. And what else? And there are actually other few terms also. You can add it to a list after you listen to this. That's all I can remember right now. Like tinea capitis, tinea corporis, tinea cruris, tinea manum, tinea pedis. Okay. And this tinea is also known as ringworm, red itchy lesions. And coming to chirion, it has a word I, and flavus, remember, it has a word S. Chirion is something related to inflammation. It is a boggy swelling, boggy lesion on scalp. Coming to flavus, it is associated what is known as scutula. These scutula is nothing but flavus, that is scutula, is associated with crust formation. This is also on the scalp only. Coming to ectothrix and endothrix, ecto is outside, endo is inside. The word tells you this. What is there outside is outside the hair shaft. We have what is known as arthrospore. Inside the hair shaft, if they have arthrospores, this is known as endothrix. This is very important that you should know. And remember, friends, these arthrospores are sexual spores. Dermatophytes basically can have two types of spores, that is sexual spores and asexual spores. Sexual spores, you have what is known as arthrospores. Asexual is conidiospores. And one more thing is you should remember the various shapes. Coming to trichophyton, it is pencil shaped. Remember, friends, this conidia is of two types, macroconidia and microconidia. Now I'm talking about macro part. Macroconidia is pencil shaped in trichophyton, thin, slender, and it is, as we said, it was branched, right? So this is trichophyton, pencil shaped. Coming to the next one, that is microsporum, it is spindle shape organ, and it is septate. And last one is epidermophyton. You should remember, epidermophyton is pear shape, club shape, something like this, okay? And it is also septate. And you should also remember that there is something called, as I said before, microconidia. Coming to microconidia, trichophyton has numerous microconidias, whereas microsporum have few of them, whereas epidermophyton doesn't have microconidia in them. Okay, that is, the microconidia is abundant here, and only few are present in microsporum. And coming to epidermum, there are no microconidia. This is all about superficial mycosis. Try to learn by correlating things. all in one. I have tried to cover all the important points in one place. Try to read as much as possible. Try to push yourself daily. Somehow try to be engaged and try to be on a positive side of yourself.